Welcome to all, myself Professor Deshmukh MS presenting the theory lecture based on torsional vibrations. So what exactly is the torsional vibrations? Torsional vibration is quite simple. Whatever the forces or the vibrations along the angular directions with the axis of rotations, that is called as what? Torsional vibrations. Introduction to the torsional vibration. What exactly is torsional? It is the oscillatory twisting of the shaft in the rotor assembly that is superimposed to the running speed. The frequency can be externally forced or can be eigenvalues. The resonance will occur if a forcing frequency coincides with the natural frequency. Individual turbo machines rotors are visually stiff enough in torsions to avoid the typical torsional excitations frequency range. Figure shows that turbo machine drive train, four torsionally stiff rotors connected by the three torsionally soft couplings. The typical high speed drive train includes a motor and gearbox driving rotating machines through the flexible couplings. Simple model of the torsional vibrations. Figure illustrates the first torsional elastic mode. Flexibility of the coupling is the dominant source of the coupled. The synchronous electric motors can be produced pulsating torque at a low frequency during the startup. The system so simple, only has a single natural frequency and the low enough to be excited by the most typical sources of torsional vibrations, excitations. Simple model of torsional vibrations. Figure illustrate the simple things. Okay, that the case. Torsional vibrations, okay, torsional model of the compressor drive. Now the coupling failures or something is there, just like the twisting, the torsional shear, the cracking of the shaft due to the metal fatigue. Why the fatigue? That is cyclic loading which is acting on it. They usually arises in the vicinity of stress and concentrations and propagations of the 45 degree. So gear and wear rapid, the shaft key failures, high noise level, presence of first torsional mode in the lateral vibration signals. Now this is again the failure comes. Coupling and connected shafts are relatively low torsional stiffness. Yielding. Now yielding of the coupling is done. Okay. The torsional vibration uses a more commonly associated with the diesel engine. So now this is very important. Torsional vibrations are issues are mostly in the diesel engine, not in the petrol engine or any gas-based engines are there. Drive electric generators are also there and marine propeller, which are the again example. The torsional natural frequency are typically low, less than 40-60 Hz. Torsional vibrations model, 2 degree of freedom, that is 2 natural frequency. Since this model has no stiffness to ground, 1 natural frequency is equal to 0 and correspond to the unrestrained rigid body rotation of the train. Torsional stiff systems models of any level of compulsivity will in general have exactly 1-0 frequency mode frequency corresponding to the rigid body rotation of the entire train. A figure shows that there is a torsions of the different models. Fn is given upon twice n divided by k into j plus j1 and divided by j1 into j2. Polar momentum, you can see comparison of the torsional and that of the lateral vibrations. Torsional requires a special instrumentations, while in the case of lateral, that is through the standard instrumentations, detections many of the cases. The large amplitude are not noticed until the coupling or the gear fails. But what happens in the large amplitudes are notified are rubbing interstage of the cell. Stresses always result in the stress revivals with a potential for the last fatigue and in the lateral synchronous vibrations. There are no revivals. The stress is constant with the circular orbits. So again comes through the different parts of this. Rarely the expenses the instantaneously. This is the excitations. The subject of the self excitations in the lateral vibrations. Analysis. The analysis must be include all the rotors in the train. But each rotor can often to be treated as a result. Analysis can usually be performed separately on the each body in the train. Two inertias are connected by the single spring. Driver and the load. Elastic shaft, that is theta and theta 2. Lowest mode of the rigid body, omega n is equal to 0, psi 1 is equal to is 1, that is mode shape. This is the picture showing the driver and load. It's quite easier. Id into 0, 0 upon I omega theta and the delta theta. Look at this figure. Figure is quite easier, which is having the case. So which will be the driver and the load with R, L, P and G. Now the nuclear frequency and the modes. Quite easier simplifications. So the driver load and the driven load. So this is again the natural frequency of the modes shapes, which will be simplified by the different angles. Hence the first root states. Now the quite easier here, the torsional vibrations, not only the difference here, that the torsions required the twisting and twisting required the angular rotations. Through the angular rotations that we are got the twisting moment and twisting moment. So the different drivers and loads are available with the case. K theta divided by I equivalent is to 0.5. This is what we have to pay the square root of. Square root of all this, from that we got something, driver and the load. Psi 1 is equal to 1 and 1. Omega square in the EOM is obtained. Okay. So simple the things, that omega, psi 1. So in the torsional vibrations again, most of the example, that is coupling shaft, these are the twisting applications where they exist.